out of the 28 states in India, Maharashtra is the second largest with 9% of population of India, and it contributes 15% of GDP of the country. It is highly industrialized, very urbanized, and it is rapidly urbanizing. Therefore, water becomes the key economic driver. There is a regulatory system because the complexities of water sector and the challenges in water sector are too huge. So the regulatory authority, which consists of four experts and chairman, has got lot many challenges. I'll just mention about three challenges before you. One is because of rapid urbanization, about 400 plus municipal bodies with 10,000 plus population and up to 20 million. They discharge about 8,000 million liters of wastewater per day. The installed capacity is only 70% and the running capacity is only 35%. What is the reason? Reason is that this is a neglected subject. Wastewater treatment is not a popular subject. It's not a glamorous subject. What is glamorous? Roads, buildings, airports, other things which you can see and appreciate. But underground drainage system getting treated outside the city, just not impressing the public. Second, it is not a viable option because you have to put in a lot of money and there is no return. Third, it is absolutely non-glamorous. Authority is proposing to do some innovations. One is that we would like to allocate some government land on lease basis to the operator. So the operator uses the treated water to certain standards, prescribed standards, and use it in the leased land for producing vegetables and fruits for the city. Therefore, the city people get fresh vegetables, fresh fruits at a reasonable rate, and the operator gets money out of it, and he can plow it in the operations. So the cost of operations will go down, viability will go up. The second challenge is that cost of water production in Maharashtra, or the economic cost, which is much higher, is here. We need to tell the people that this is the economic cost in Maharashtra for water, this is the production cost, and you are paying this. So the tariff has to increase and the mindset has to be changed. How do we change the mindset? We compare with things like cell phone charges for a family, eating out twice a week in the family, cable TV charges, and also similar other charges which the family is spending. It is important. However, we must also tell the people that paying for water is also important. If you do not pay, then tomorrow sustainability will be under a big question mark. This we have to do through the youth, through people like you who can spread the message and say that we have to agree to pay a little more. Therefore, the mindset has to be changed. Resistance of people for when the increase in tariff is done by the regulator has to be reduced. The third most important challenge for the authority is that Maharashtra has got four prominent river basins. The western basin, which is adjoining the Arabian Sea, is receiving about 45% of precipitation, but it has to irrigate only 10% of the area. The eastern side of the mountain ranges, it receives about 28% of precipitation, but it has to irrigate about 50% of the area. Therefore, there is a highly deficit basin and there is a highly surplus basin. The question is how to transfer this entire water which is lost to the Arabian Sea, how to transfer that to the east of the mountain ranges, which has average height of 1200 meters. It runs across the coast. Along the coast, it is 720 kilometers and the width is about 100 kilometers. We have technologies, but they're expensive. Energy costs are too much. So I leave the thought with you, how to reduce the cost, how to bring in better technology to transfer water to the eastern side of the mountain ranges. That will really propel the economic growth of the state. There are other issues, other challenges, but I would like to connect with you later on one-to-one basis to enter into a dialogue. Thank you so much.